Hey guys, Mike here, One Go Short Play. Today we are playing a little game I like to call Blockout for the Sega Mega Drive. I don't like to call it that, it's what it's called. I've never seen it before in my life. It's clearly a Tetris clone, unless I'm very much mistaken. That was snazzy for 1991. Let's play some Tetris Mega Drive style. Oh, okay, Weltris it is then. Was it Weltris? It's something very similar to that. I was never any good at Weltris. It just did me head in. A bit like this is currently doing. So, ooh, that's slow and... Ooh, I see. Up goes up. Yeah, this is doing me head in already. And that rotates that way. Oh, this is not right. Oh, this is wrong. This is all kinds of wrong. A's got to drop it. No, it doesn't. How'd you drop it? Start button. Start button, you drop it. Okay. Oh, this is weird. I don't like it. I can't think fast enough, even for this slow game. Even for this game at its slowest, I'm not quick enough. Oh, I quite like it. No, I don't like it. No, I like it. I don't like it. I don't like it. Oh, I like it. Oh, that's a handy little block, isn't it? Am I there? There. No. I want that one. Oh, I don't like it. I don't like this. I don't. You're on there. Oh, that was a big one. How big's that one? Oh, it's two. I can see the two now. Oh, I don't like this. Oh. Oh, I like it. Oh, this was dead weird. That's the one. Down you go. I like it. How many are you? Just the one, apparently. Okay. Oh, this is... I don't like it. It freaks me out. See, Weltris, I hate it. I just hated it. I couldn't get it at all, Weltris. I didn't enjoy it, and I think that was the essential difference with Tetris and Weltris. Tetris was simplicity itself, and the beauty of that game was in its simplicity. And its perfect design, you know, it was like, it didn't take that much work for the people who designed Tetris, and I can't remember the name of the person, people who did that. I'm not particularly a Tetris fanboy, but I do appreciate what a wonderful piece of game design it was. Because it was so Nintendo exclusive, I think, back in the day, and I was, you know, a Sega kid. And by that I mean, I just happened upon a Sega before I happened upon a Nintendo. Don't get me wrong, there's no necessarily misplaced loyalties. That said, I do prefer the Sega kind of mentality of the time. It was less Disney, you know, less goofy. Goofy as in, you know, the state of mind, not the character. Sega was kind of aimed at me, teenagers of the 90s, I guess. Which was cool, and, you know, they were naive in the way they did it, but it was still, at least, they still made the effort. Nintendo were just like, yeah, take it or leave it. If you're not five, you probably won't like it. Anyway, that aside, Tetris was a Nintendo-y thing. It was a Game Boy-y thing. It was associated... I know it was on everything else in various forms, especially the likes of, ooh, the Amiga, which I also had and was very into, you know, through the kind of PD market. But is that the right place? No, it's not. Move over. There we go. And there. Go. Oh, that was so wrong. Wrong answer. Oh, wrong answer, Mike. I've just messed the whole game up. I'm not sure that was completely fair. I'm sure I'll look back and go, yeah, Mike, you divvy. That was completely fair. You know, there was loads of it on the Amiga. I'm sure there was variants of Tetris on the Mega Drive eventually. Maybe I'm wrong about that answer on a postcard. But, I didn't, you know, get into Tetris as a cultural thing because I didn't get into Nintendo as a cultural thing. I made a mess of this with that one move before, didn't I? Interesting. Okay, let's see if we can resolve this orange layer. I can see what happens. The layers become the colour when they go down. I like that. It's a nice touch. I'm not very skilled at this, you might have noticed. I want that way, and that way, and that way. Yeah. Now, that said, I do totally appreciate what a great game Tetris was. Is? Yeah, is. Was. Tetris was. Sorry, I went a bit Alan Partridge then. Yeah. I do appreciate what a great game Tetris was, of course. It's just I didn't play it that much. And when I played a lot of kind of Tetris clones on the Amiga and a lot of games that were trying to, you know, take the Tetris model and better it. And there's nothing wrong with doing that. I do that quite a lot with my own little indie games. If I get around to making them. But I take old kind of game ideas, put a few of the best ones together and see what comes out the other end, you know. Yeah, that worked. But no one ever really improved on Tetris. And by adding this third dimension, and well, Tris, I'm talking to you. Again, no one ever improved on it. In fact, I'd argue that Weltris just overcomplicated it and made a very unplayable game, in my opinion. Of course, I am not the oracle and be all and all this stuff, far from it. That's just my opinion. This is my channel. I get to give it. It's great. I did really enjoy Tetris more than any of this stuff. That said, I started off playing this thinking, oh god, it's Weltris. If Weltris was this, if this is, I mean, if this is a pretty much perfect clone of Weltris, which I'm sure it's not, this is way better than I remember Weltris being. This is really good. I like it. That might not be my final word on whether I like or not this game or not. But right now, I think because I'm not, it's very cerebral. Much more so than Tetris. It doesn't seem to have that by now playing Tetris, that panic thing would have kicked in, you know. That kind of, it's getting too high. Now it's probably getting too high, but I don't really care. I'm feeling quite chilled out about it all. It's a one-y, isn't it? It is a one-y. I'm feeling quite chilled out about it all, and I'm starting to get this. I'm really starting to enjoy it. Uh-oh, that's a new layer. I need to get my act together if I'm going to get some of these layers down. Oh, no. Oh, that'll do. I didn't mean to do that. You can probably tell. It's a bit inaccurate. See, I hit it once then, and it went two. And I hit it once, and it went once. He's done it again. It goes two sometimes when you want it to go one. Does that make sense? It goes two squares sometimes when you want it to go one square. What I do like is I can change this in three dimensions and get the exact shape I want, which is great. You can't do that in Tetris. So I can do that. That's a two-y, isn't it? Yeah. Oh, well. It'll do. And I can put this two-y. So I'm already developing my own vocabulary for this game. It's a particularly scouse in its styles, I think. A 2-y and a 1-y is the sort of thing that I'd probably hear amongst my mates when I was a kid in Liverpool. Yeah, okay. Well, sort of, yeah. That could probably have been handled a little better. See, I've got all these little 1-y holes that I'm filling in with pieces that shouldn't really fit into 1-y holes. I see how the 3D works out. It's really nice, actually. I don't want to get too technical on you. I think you can see what the game is without me explaining all its technicalities, and quite frankly I'd be very ineloquent in explaining those technicalities. I think most of my viewers, the ones I know, have the channels and view mine occasionally, would probably be much more eloquent in describing this game than I would. That said, I suppose I should really try. Nah, you can see what I'm doing. You can see what this is. It's good. It's good. I actually really like it. I'm not going to get too detailed, as I say. It's, you know what? Oh, that was a 1-y. I thought that was a 4-y. It's a really good take on the Tetris idea. As I say, I really loathed Weltris. I'm having trouble seeing where the shapes are after a few colours go down, I have to admit. Like, now I'm not sure what's going to happen if I drop that. Is the orange above the yellow? Is the yellow above the orange? Yellow above the orange. That's a wrong move waiting to happen. Uh-oh, too late. Too late. Oh, no, we're into blue territory. But that's just as well. My time's pretty much up here. Yeah. Quality game. Probably underrated. I sort of want to play it a bit more. But I suppose I should check out some more games. Yeah, I will. Okay. Pretty good. Very nice surprise. Let's see what happens when you die. That was Blockout. Ooh, it's getting scary now. Oh, no. Wow, you get quite a lot of chances. Yeah, game over, man. Game over. That was Blockout for the Sega Mega Drive. Actually, rather good. Thanks very much for watching.